The zombie apocalypse is upon us. It's just not exactly what we expected.
We call these crabs zombie crabs.
An invasive parasite takes over their body and brain.
It castrates infected crabs. Their behavior completely changes. We see male crabs acting like female crabs. They live their entire life to protect the parasite inside them.
Essentially transforming the crabs into parasite-producing machines.
It's almost like The Last of Us, but with crabs.
And changing weather might be helping them thrive.
Around the 1960s, an invasive parasite was introduced into the Chesapeake Bay.
Ironically, by hitchhiking on oysters used for coastal restoration efforts.
This parasite is a zombifying parasite, and it infects our local mud crabs. We like to refer to it by its nickname, Loxo. They actually look a lot more like a fungus.
That's parasite.
What these parasites do after they infect a crab, they take over all of the tissues on the inside of the crab. They castrate the crab, so the crab cannot have any more babies. This is why we call the parasite a zombifying parasite, and we call these crabs zombie crabs. Because in biology, once a crab, or once any animal, cannot reproduce anymore, we kind of consider it functionally dead.
Though the parasite is very much alive and trying to spread its eggs.
Now, Loxo parasites depend on relatively higher salinity waters in order to survive and reproduce.
That is, it releases thousands of parasite babies from its outer organ to seek out a new crab host.
We see 90% of our crabs have this parasite.
And climate and weather could very much impact its spread.
So what we see with warming temperatures, climate change, we also see sea level rise. And that means that higher salinity waters are encroaching further into our rivers, further into our water bodies that formerly were very fresh water. And that encroaching salinity is also going to bring infected crabs with it.
Changing waters means changing crabs.
What this parasite does to male crabs specifically, it infects them and it actually makes them look like a female. It grows an outer organ, kind of like a mushroom, on the bottom of the crab. It makes them think that they have eggs. It thinks that it's a female and it thinks that it has eggs to protect.
And this is where it gets into Walking Dead territory.
This guy's got a big old parasite right there.
Which could have serious consequences for bay ecosystems.
Mud crabs are a really common species. They actually form the basis of the food chain in a lot of our estuaries. A really important species, really important predator species, like our shorebirds, certain large fish. So we do expect that this parasite might actually have a negative impact on the mud crab population, which will then cascade up through the food chain and negatively impact the rest of our ecosystem.
All reason to keep tabs on these little zombies.
We go out and we actually set out crab traps all along the many rivers that go into the Chesapeake Bay. We pull our crab traps out and they're actually full of oyster shells, dead oyster shells, because mud crabs love oysters.
One thing zombified crabs don't love? Big storms.
When we have heavy rainfall, we could see a lowering of salinity. We have this influx of fresh water. That actually prevents this parasite from reproducing in certain areas. So that might actually be a good thing for managing this parasite. It could probably kill off a lot of our crabs that are infected because they're just not as robust. They're just not as healthy.
Which means weather can also be one of the greatest weapons against these body snatchers.
That's why it's so important for us to study this Loxo species in our mud crabs, because we can have a really good idea of how these invasions work, potentially how to prevent them and how to manage them.